Well, hello. Yoink. 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 Friends, are you ready for another round of very unscientific chemistry? For I have collected staghorn lichen, a lichen that is ammonia reactive and is promised to give us pink purple dye. And you know I am excited for that. I've got two pickle jars. Let's fill it kind of with the lichen that I have. I might have gone a little bit overboard with the collecting of the lichen, but fear not, there was plenty still in the forest. I also only picked the ones that were lying on the forest floor, so nothing that was still attached to a tree, and even those that were on the forest floor attached to a twig, I also did not take because they can still continue living if they are connected to a dead branch. But these were all connected to absolutely nothing. Approximately halfway with ammonia, and then fill the rest with water. It's not the color that it promises to give, but then that is immediately very vibrant as well. And now we must wait. I also filled this little pot with some green shield lichen, and oh my god, that's so dark already. It's like actually a heat wave right now in Belgium. It's about 36 degrees right now, and I think the heat might, you know, speed up the fermentation a little bit. Green shield lichen is supposed to give yellow or orange. I hope orange. We're now 2 weeks into this waiting game of fermenting the lichen in ammonia, and I hope you can see how bright red this has already become. Not this is more of a brown, but then again, we are expecting a orange color, not purple. If I shake it, you can really see the foam becoming orange. I'm going to give them a little bit extra oxygen today, so that the fermentation can continue. Of course, they have sucked themselves vacuum again. I've got to get underneath the lid to introduce some air so I can actually open these jars, because I am silly weak, especially in my hands, wrists and arms. As proven by my inability to open this jar. Look at that bright red color. So promising, so promising. Like, there is some discoloration on the lid that actually already looks a little bit purple. I know, we're not nearly close to being done, but I'm really excited for this. It's looking like it's going to turn out okay. Week 4, color check. Very red already. I don't know if it's much redder than on week 2, but just going to have it further develop.
and air out some more. Now, during Tour de Fleece, someone in the comment section actually said that they read somewhere on a Facebook group that you shouldn't air out these lichen dyes because it deteriorates the color. Now, what I have gathered from the information that I read on the internet is that what we want to do is create a pigment called orchil, and that is done by a process of oxidation, and I think the word itself indicates that oxidation needs oxygen. So I'm adding oxygen to my oxidation process to hopefully create orchil. Not the case for the orange one, but that is turning very orange already. I think this one is actually almost done, but I want to use my dye pot for something else in the near future, so I'm just keeping it in its pot anyway. Like, is there harm in it developing a little bit further? I don't know. We will see later.
So it's been over 2 months since I started fermenting my lichen in these pots. I'm getting a little bit antsy. Like, you know, 2.5 months of waiting, that's a lot for me. So I want to start experimenting with them. At least I'm going to try to get some color out of the green shield lichen, because that wasn't all that much lichen for the pot. So I don't know what my reasoning is behind it, but not so much lichen probably means that it is done faster. Correct me if I'm wrong. And then I might, if I have time today, because I only have today, because tomorrow I will have to go to work, I might try one of the two Oakmoss lichen pots. I have two. I mean, I can try one, see if it is done, and if it's not, then leave the other one for 2.5 months longer. I don't know. First, I want to try green shield lichen because somehow I want to see bright orange today.
If you could guess, like orange, I'm in an orange mood. Now to start experimenting with it, I have some fluff and also some yarn in a pot with alum mordant. I know that lichen dyes most probably don't need a mordant, but it also never hurts to add a mordant, just to be sure that we get the brightest possible color. So that's why I'm mordanting this. We're still working with ammonia, so pro tip, ventilate your space well. I mean, this is a pro tip for every time you dye with any kind of dye, acid dye, natural dyeing, just ventilate your space. Let's try and dye this little bit of yarn. That's our first sacrifice to the lichen gods. That's a light orange already. I hope that by leaving it in there, like for an hour or something, we'll get a bright orange. I said an hour or something. Well, this is the result after 7 to 8 hours. It really seems to be a slow dye. Like in the beginning, there wasn't much color getting onto the yarn. It was very pale beige. Now it's getting like a warm, autumn-like brown. I like this. But I also do think it's not entirely done. The water is still really dark. So I'm going to keep this in the water, I think overnight, and then see what that does. So after a couple of sequences of heating and cooling down my dye bath, this is eventually the final color. I think this is the deepest we can get. Now, I think on screen it's a little bit blown out, but in real life it's a really warm golden brown. It's not the orange that I wanted, but it is really pretty and I think a really deep color for, I didn't even have 10 grams of green shield lichen to start with, I think. It was not really a lot of dye stuff. So I am amazed at how deep a color I could achieve with it. It's also not a lot of yarn. I am aware of the fact that this is not a big skein of yarn, but I mean, if I had more Greenshield lichen, I could have had more yarn and maybe even a deeper brown color. And this is, I love this color. It's so soft, so warm, so golden. And you know, this result makes me even more excited to try the Oakmoss lichen. Shall we? Shall we attempt? Shall we attempt? When I shake my jug, the foam is very red. Like, the dream, the ideal would be to get purple. But red would be so cool too. So I do not longer want to wait. Like, between starting this dye and today, there are a couple of weeks past. We are now at the very end of September. This lichen has been in that pot for 3 months now. I think it's time to evict him, or at least out of one pot. And then I'll keep the second one longer and do an update, maybe in a couple of weeks, couple of months time, if anything has changed. So let's do it. Oh, god damn it. Can't open the jar. Just a sec. Aha. In this bath, I'm going to put an unmordanted skein of yarn, also just a little tiny one. And a bit of mordanted Campis scarp fleece. Hopefully this doesn't take as long as the Greenshield lichen did. And now we wait. So it's been here in here for now an hour or something. It's also looking kind of brown, but I don't know if you can see the difference. This brown has clearly a more of a rose, almost purple tint. So I think if I repeat that same process of heating, cooling down, I might get something interesting with this. The fiber, however, is not as pink. That really is a tint of beige, so that's interesting. This was mordanted, if you remember. We are 24 hours later after a first heating and cooling cycle. That is looking promising. It's a very soft, warm, purple tone brown, I'd say. I don't know if the color comes across really good on camera, but let's heat it up once more, continue the cycle. I think we can get a much deeper color out of this. Yeah, especially on the fluff. This is not much color yet. I am once again going on a heating cycle for this evernia prunastri, I think, dye bath. However, this morning I took out one of the skeins of yarn and, friends, it is so pretty. Let me show you. Finding it difficult, if not impossible, to find a background that shows off the true color of this yarn on camera. I feel like it's an elusive color that just doesn't want to be picked up by camera. Like, both are brown. Honest to God, they are brown. This one is the green shield lichen and this is the oak moss lichen. They are both brown. However, as you can see, there are completely different browns. This is golden brown texture like sun. You know, such a golden soft brown, like a field of grain dancing in the wind. That's what this reminds me of. But this, I have a hard time describing it. Sometimes it does look a little bit purple. Other times it goes more towards burgundy. It really differs in what light you're looking at it. It's such an interesting color. But again, it's also brown. I think these two together also just pair so nicely, like a tiny little colorwork scarf or something with these two would just be peak autumn. The autumn vibes are strong with this, like really strong. Right, these are just perfect peak autumn colors. I really enjoy this. Now, I didn't really achieve red or purple. I am going to continue heating and cooling down my existing dye bath with the Oakmoss lichen, see what I can get, but then also I am going to place this jar somewhere and then forget about its existence for the next couple of months. And we will see at a later date if leaving this for longer might yield better results. More purple, more red, like at least magenta or something, I don't know. Right now, pretty brown, but it's still brown, and that's not really what I was going for. Very happy with the brown, but still not really what I was going for, and I still would like to achieve at least a truer red than this, or a truer purple, one of the two. Another thing that surprises me a little bit is how soft the yarn still is. Like, both of these yarns have been in a very acidic environment for quite a while, or and you know, the ammonia probably has evaporated over time, but they don't feel brittle or broken by the acidity, and I'm quite content with that. They still feel as soft as in the beginning. So this is my result for now. I will, as I have said, leave that pot and continue experimenting with whatever is in my dye pot, and I will see you at a later date with those results. But these are the results for now. Pretty deep and vibrant as well. I haven't said that, maybe, I don't know, but ooh. A lot of color in these yarns, like, yeah, pretty vibrant color uptake. I like that. This was a very fun dyeing experiment, and I will see you on a future date with more lichen experiments. Anyway, if you like these kind of fiber shenanigans, then maybe you could like, comment, or subscribe, but of course that is all up to you. And as for me, I will see you in the next video. But before we do that, maybe you could look at some more dyeing experiments. Bye!